Immediately after a tea break, I would believe that you're all refreshed. And let's move on from the discussion on the blockchain to supply chain. It's far more simpler, I would say, as compared to blockchain. And supply chain, we always used to think it's far more complex, but when we heard the discussion a little while ago, blockchain seems to be much more complex. The complexity of this particular presentation for us lies in the fact that initially we were given 25 minutes, and I was told that you have to round it up in 15 minutes. So we are pretty used to this when we work in supply chain. Coming from chemical industry, I will speak about the chemical industry by and large and the related supply chain. The topic given to us basically was to talk about efficient and smart supply chain and how we are doing it in our organization. If you look about the chemical industry in the country, it's close to around $150 billion. Quite sizable, I would say. And we were just discussing about Mr. Mukesh Ambani. So Reliance happens to be one of the industry leading in the chemical segment in the country. It is sixth largest in the world and third largest in agrochemicals. And this is specifically talking about the chemical industry in the country. We have a strong consumer base in India, and this will continue to drive the growth of the chemical industry at an average rate of close to around 8 to 10% year on year for far more many years to come. The characteristics of the industry, as I mentioned, it has got a great demand potential. The government is making it easy for the organizations to work. So it's creating the right kind of an infrastructure and the environment for the industry. The R&D facilities are gearing up in the country. The IP rights, people are getting more aware. And with the challenges the industries have seen in China, I think it's time for India to gear up for those developments on this front. Areas which concerns us, the supply chain, and since it's the discussion, like the entire day has been spent about talking on the SMEs, the startups, the unicorns, the Amazons and the Flipkarts of the world, they are creating a value proposition to the end consumer because of their supply chain. In spite of that, in different industries, supply chain is still continues to be a fragmented industry. We are a net importer in India. We export more and export less and import more. And the major challenge is we have a low feedstock advantage. We don't have a lot of oil and gas. We import, our biggest import bill comes in from import of oil. And that's the reason you won't find many big petrochemical complexes other than the ones which have been put up by Reliance, SR, or say the PSUs coming up, or where the multinational corporations, even the corporations like us, are setting up in the country because we don't have the feedstock advantage. Where are we headed to? In each and everything we use, right from the time we get up in the morning till the time we go to bed, it has a touch of chemical, right from the toothbrush to the toothpaste to the bed on which we sleep. So the demand potential is pretty high. We need to create environment where we are able to provide differentiated services to our end consumers. We need to create growth in the market for the chemical industry. We look forward to the government to continue providing us platform which enables growth for the chemical industry. There have been certain initiatives which government has taken up in the last decade or so, and PCPIR was one such, or is such an initiative which was kick-started by the government to create petrochemical, chemical, and petroleum industrial complexes. But unfortunately, as I mentioned, the feedstock disadvantage is not able to scale up the kind of productions or, say, the volumes we thought we are going to see in this particular sector. But still, a lot more can be done. And this is a time of change. The technology is a disruptor to each and every business. So we have to create our digital map, digital footprints. The organizations are moving in from a different phase to the new phase. The fourth revolution in the manufacturing sector is the talk of the town. And I think for many, many more years, like we were hearing the other panelists talking about the internet as a boon, technology is going to play a major role the way we operate and do businesses all around the world. So who are we? It's an altogether different platform, and I come in from the chemical industry, as I told you. Maybe not many of you are aware of who we are as an organization. In India, just to give you a brief, we are $1.2 billion organization, so not an SME for sure, but we work with a lot of SMEs who are our partners. We supply to them, we buy from them, we associate ourselves. They are our channel partners, service providers. We are located at 11 different places in the country, 4 manufacturing sites, so we are manufacturing chemicals. 2 center of excellences, and when I say center of excellence, that means we have outsourced these activities of back-end services to our partners, and we are doing global operations of certain functions and businesses in India. So we are exporting services out of India. We have created a technology center, consolidated from 3 different centers to 1 very recently. All in all, we are close to around 1,000 people. And since safety and compliance remains the highest priority in our organization, all our sites are responsible care certified. Our global expertise, just to quickly touch on, in 2016, our global turnover was $48 billion, so we are the largest chemical corporations in the United States. And currently, with the merger of Dow and DuPont, we are the largest chemical company in the world with close to around $80 billion. In the years to come, in another 1 year or so, we are going to be separated out into 3 different chemical corporations, one taking care of agrochemical, one material sciences, and another specialty. As you can see, we work on end-to-end solutions. We file a lot of patents. And there are, when I talk of companies like Dow and DuPont, there are marquee products or, say, technologies which we have been using since last so many years. Both organizations put together, it brings in more than 300 years of experience. How are we harnessing the power of digital? As I said, it's the times of change, and we are talking about digitalization, innovation, automation. We in our organization are putting things together and trying to change the way we work. We are trying to be much more smarter. We have identified key areas. We are bringing in technologies. We are enabling solutions so that we can work smarter, faster, and we can be much, much more closer to our customers than what we had been in the past. So a lot of innovation is going in this direction. As you can see, we are trying to simplify things, and we are trying to shift towards the customer. So our thought process is think end-to-end and think based on the customer need and demand. Our approach, we are aligned to meet our goals and aligned to meet business strategies and customer expectations. If supply chain strategy is not aligned to the business strategy, I am very sure the organizations are not going to succeed, because this is the core of the organization. including manufacturing and engineering, including the logistics and the customer service. It's all part of the integrated supply chain. So we have to be aligned towards a customer-centric environment, and this is what we are trying, and we are changing. In the current times, we have gone through the biggest merger in the chemical industry last year, and this is the time we are changing our processes and we are aligning to the new technologies and embracing the new processes so that it can make us more efficient in the years of tomorrow. We have rolled out demand planning to fulfillment when it comes to supply chain. And we are creating solutions based on the customer demand. It's demand-driven supply chain. We are trying to be more lean. We are trying to create competitive advantage through an effortless customer experience. And when I say customer experience, together in any of the organizations, whether it's an SME or a global organization, Indian organization, small, big, whatever size you talk of, customer experience and employee experience is what matters. And when you are able to connect and harness the power of customer experience and employee experience directly, it's directly proportional to the EBITDA of the organization. And the customer experience is something we are working on a very focused way to create solutions to the customer and creating solutions which are end-to-end and meeting the demand of the customer. We are centralizing a lot of operations so that we are in a position to reduce silos, because in larger organizations which have presence in different countries, it's not that we only sell what we produce in India to India. We bring in a lot of material from outside. We have to coordinate with a lot of people. We need that connect. We need that understanding that everyone thinks aligned and everyone is thinking about the customer. So we are putting people together. We are creating centers and we are removing those barriers which were creating some kind of disturbances in meeting the customer expectations. And as long as we are able to meet the customer expectations, we will be in a position to provide the solutions which are kind of Amazon-like experience, we call it. Making supply chain smart. We have introduced demand planning to fulfillment. Fulfillment coming in from the customer perspective, not from what we want to sell. We want to be fluid, flexible, agile, simplified, automated, digital. We are bringing in a lot of technologies. We are working with a lot of global partners. We want to be a game changer in the industry where we are. And we want to connect end to end. End to end means till the time we receive the payment from the customer and the demand is generated in the system, we are trying to connect end to end. And until and unless we have these solutions which are seamlessly connected, we will not get the results, and that's what is our vision. Delivering last mile excellence, as I said, it starts with customer, it ends with customer. Customer-centric approach. We need to have customer in our mind to all the operations and functions and the processes we do within our organization. And this is the mantra of success, and this is going to be the mantra of success to any organization, as I said, though it be big, small. We are creating the scale to produce, just to give you a brief and let you know. In Middle East, very close, in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, we have a joint venture which was put up with the investment of $20 billion. And it's a joint venture between our organization and Saudi Aramco. The scale of those operations are world class, and we will be supplying material which will be manufactured very close to us to regions like India, Asia, Pacific, and Africa. So we are creating the scale which are closer to the demand centers so that we can reduce the time cycle, we can be closer to the customer. We are creating integrated service center, as I mentioned, integrated service centers, all functions, and the people who are required to meet the demand of the customer at one place, so that they can talk to each other, they can approach each other, and there are no time lags in taking right decisions, which helps to meet the customer demand. From the technology point of view, we are working in India specifically with some of the startups in the logistics industry, and this is just one example I put up for your reference. Nicer Globe is a platform which is working under the umbrella of ICC, which is Indian Chemical Council. It was kick-started by seven like-minded companies to bring in visibility of the shipments. We do move a lot of hazardous shipments when we talk of chemicals, and also create the level one emergency response in case of any untoward incident. The service provider here is a startup, Techno Purple. We are working with another the startup in the logistics industry. We have worked very closely with LogiNext. We are working with Freight Tiger. So we are trying to bring in a lot of visibility of the shipment so that we know at any given point in time where our shipments are, because we have to move material all across the country, right from south to north, east to west, the places you name. So this is the advantage of being digital and bringing in visibility. We are generating a lot of data, so data analytics is also playing a key role. We are using the data analytics for the advantage of ours to reduce cost and to reduce time. The faster we are able to reach customer, the lesser the inventory we are able to keep, the lower will be the cost. And we need to be efficient, but we also need to be responsive. So it's a right mix we need to strike. Gate check tool, again, is one such thing which we have implemented together under the platform of Nicer Globe. It's a tab-based solution which does the checking of the vehicles when it comes for loading or unloading. So you can feed in the data into this tablet. The repository can be kept for years. You can do the analysis. You can even identify whether you can take the pictures of the drivers, because many a times when we transport hazardous goods, we have to give training to our drivers, and we have to keep on giving the trainings to upgrade their knowledge about what they are transporting. So the same driver is delivering the material who has loaded. We analyze any deviations. If we have restricted night driving, which we don't allow in our operations, if there are any deviations, we are able to track all this with these kind of technologies. And we are also able to provide the information uphand to our customers, like your delivery will be available to you in 2 days' time. And we have done some geofencing at different locations. So if a truck passes through that particular area, automatically it generates an email, and an email goes to the customer, look, your material has reached so-and-so place, and these many hours later, it is going to touch your plant. So these are certain things, certain initiatives which we have kick-started, which we are trying to provide Amazon-like experience, and it's not only in India, it's a global drive. Technologies are pushing us to change, and we are pretty receptive on that front. We are trying to harness the power and provide better solutions to our customers and enable much, much, much more better customer experience.